How's it going, guys? So, I'm back at the shop and everything. It always feels good to be back in my surroundings, the smell of the shop, just everything in general. I like to go travel to different spots and everything, but nothing feels better than being at home. I miss Presley, I miss Dana, all that good stuff, so I'm glad that I'm back. And I'm back on my regular schedule now, so that'll be good too. I also got some stuff while I was gone. I got a sweet little package from Charles over at FPV Aces. I don't know if you guys have ever been on his site. This is all his stuff here. You guys could even use a promo code. I think it's Konasty is a promo code, and you guys could get some stuff on a discount over there. But he sent me this frame here. I guess this is the Shendrones Butter. It's a 3-inch frame. Or Butters, I'm sorry. Butters. Cool, it's a little South Park reference. I like that. It's got these little props that he sent. These are little 3-inch Racecraft props. I don't really even know who else makes a 3-inch. I've never even seen a prop this small. It's crazy. I've seen people like post stuff about 3-inch little quads, but I've never actually seen one in person. Actually, Tommy had a Vortex one, I think. Maybe that was 4-inch. I don't know if it was a 3-inch. Check out these little motors that he sent me, too. These are the smallest little, these are the Tornado Brother Hobby 1407 3600 kV motors. They feel really good. I mean, there's, like, almost no air gap on it. The magnets feel good. And he sent me over some of these DYS, the D-Shot Ready ESCs that I'm really curious about trying these out and see how they work. I've seen them and I've been using the TBS ones, and those I use on multi-shot, but these run D-Shot. And I like the D-Shot on the KISS ESCs, but I've really been liking Betaflight lately. I've used that all-in-one Combini board on my 6-inch. Betaflight's been feeling so good. The only quad I have is my 5-inch that's running the D-Shot KISS ESCs. It's full KISS setup. That's the only one I have is my 5-inch stuff has the full KISS. All my 6-inch stuff is running the multi-shot TBS ones and the Betaflight. But today, I am going to upgrade my Betaflight. I know they have, like, I think it's 3.1 out, and I've been using the 3.0, the last version of that, and it's been amazing with, like, little vibrations and things and all that stuff. It's just been really locked in to where, you know, KISS is a really sensitive to a lot of things, like when you crash and stuff like that. Betaflight is not, so that's why I like Betaflight. But yeah, I'm going to upgrade. I'll probably do it with you guys right now. So let's grab everything and try it out. And maybe, I don't know if I'll get time, but we'll try and fly maybe in the front over here and see what happens. Alright, so I need to get my prop tool, and check this out. I wanted to show you guys this. This here is the Think Tank helipack bag, and this is the one I usually use that we talked about. This is a session bag. I filled this whole bag up with everything that I needed for my trip, including the Phantom. I have both controllers in here. I have chargers, batteries for the Phantom. That's random props, but I had my batteries. Everything was in here, and it totally, like, it was a little heavy, but it fit everything, which was amazing. For, like, a trip like that, to be able to have everything when I needed it anywhere where I was at was totally cool. But now I just need to put everything back in there. So, I just wanted to let you guys know that stuff. Check out the Think Tank stuff. Don't be scared to go over there. I know there's all the Low Pro stuff and everything. That's all special because everybody's using it. Think Tank is a really good company, quality bags, and I really enjoyed using that one. But let's get over to taking the props off this guy to do the Betaflight thing, because you don't want to be messing with stuff with the props on, especially 6-inch props, because that's scary. Alright guys, so we are all hooked up, and it found my board and everything that I'm using here. Let's see if it's got it. Cool, so I don't have to go to the website and download it. I thought I had to do that, so this is cool. I'm going to load the firmware online. You guys know how to do all this, I'm sure. Flash firmware. It's erasing, doing its thing on the bottom, right here. Okay, cool. Programming successful. Let's load into this here. Where's my mouse? Alright, we're all set up in this guy here. Everything seems to be working. We're gonna go to my ports configuration. All right, I believe it was serial RX on UART3 is what I gotta do here. Save and reboot, configuration. I've been running multi-shot and my min throttle, I've been putting it at 140 or 1040, should I say. All right, what else do we gotta do? Put SBUS into the receiver. Here, SBUS, 8K and 2K, gyro update frequency and PID loop frequency. I've been going with 4K, 4K. I take this accelerometer off, do all that good stuff, and that's pretty much it. I should have probably looked to see if anything else changed. Let's go to the very bottom real quick. Anything on here? Negative. I want to start using black box a little bit more. Eventually, maybe I'll move to the Betaflight flight controller, because that has like so much stuff you could do with it, OSD, everything. Okay, so this is the PID tuning, completely stock PIDs on here. And I want to leave them at stock PIDs and just see how they do. I do know that I'm probably going to want to change my rates up here, bump these up. I've been at 81 on these, I know that for sure, and 73 on the yaw. Okay, so set point, weight, all this stuff, I'm gonna leave all that the same. The TPA, I bring that up a little bit here, maybe I should leave that the same as well. Let's meet in the middle. 15.15, that's where I'm at. Okay, I got everything all set up and ready to go. I don't want to make this into like a lengthy PID tuning video. I do got this guy set up again, so I'm going to wear the chest harness. I'm going to kind of go over what I'm doing, and then I'm going to make a couple adjustments, and then we'll show like the after flight, and I'll go over my changes so you can see the before and after changes. And for the most part, it's a little windy outside, so that's perfect. I could adjust my eyes probably somewhere where I like them. So let's get to flying. All right, so we're gonna do a quick little lookout for some cars. I'm all good. Video looks good. All right. Little shakes right there. I kind of like to always go up and kind of fall into my prop wash and kind of see. Okay, we're a little wobbly. I like to see like where it's like shaking. Okay, so I need to adjust the eyes for sure. And let's see on the roll. Ooh, it's floating with this wind a little. Alright, so, I saw on that last one I had a little bobble too. Yeah, okay. I really see it on the pitch, which is understandable. I mean, for this, this type of frame here, where the battery's on the top. But, alright, let's bring it in. I'm gonna slowly make some changes, then I'll show you guys like the end result. So the wind's getting a little bit stronger now. We'll see how the tune is. I moved a couple things around. Alright, so they seem a little bit smoother here. Nice. I don't really have as much of the shake going into those drops. Yeah, that seems a lot better. It's fighting the wind pretty good too. I'm drifting, but you can see I'm not all wobbly. It's connecting everything pretty good. That drift is gnarly. Yeah, that's not bad. I'll take it. see if I could really get it to fall into my prop wash with the wind. Nope. I didn't see it. Maybe it'll catch it on the GoPro footage. It seems pretty good, actually. Right there is a little something, but I'm in the way of the wind right here. Whoa, that blew me over. Holy crap. This is windy. Alright, I'm gonna bring it in. Seems actually good where I like it. Might make minor adjustments in the future, but that landing was a little better than the last one. Alright, so let me show you guys where I ended up with everything. I got it hooked up over here, and hopefully you guys could see this. I ended up going with the roll 47, pitch 62, yaw 65, yada yada yada, all the way down to the end. That's pretty much where I ended up with everything. You can see my eyes got pretty high, 61, 65. Trying to fight the wind there. If you scroll on down here, let's see if I could... My TPA was 0.18, and that's at 1650. So, that's pretty much where I ended up with everything. I'll show you one more time. Alright, so thanks for watching that little impromptu PID tuning video. The thing I can say is just don't get stuck in a PID tuning trap when you're doing PID tuning, where you're just moving numbers all around everywhere, and it gets really messed up, and you don't really know what's going on. What I like to do is start the stock PIDs, I detune, especially on these 6 inches, I'll just detune everything and get it all mushy, and then kind of just work my way up from there with everything, just one at a time, just changing the settings, and it kind of just gets somewhere I like. I don't really have to have like the perfect tune, just something that feels good on the sticks for me, and it looks pretty decently good in the video when I shoot it. So that's pretty much what I go for. I don't try and become like a PID tuning expert. I just want to have something that flies well for me and feels comfortable when I'm flying it, so that way I can be confident in doing the things I want to do. One other thing is, I know some of you guys had like a Q&A type question saying I should do that kind of stuff. If you guys want to see me do a Q&A, leave me a comment below saying, yes, I want to see you do a Q&A, and here's a question for you. So that'd be, I guess, pretty fun to do. If I could get that going with you guys, I will make sure I answer as many questions as possible. And if there's anything else you guys want to see me do or want to see for me, just also, you know, you can leave that in the comments below. So, that's pretty much it. I'm back on schedule with everything here. And, yeah, you guys have a good one. Get out there. Get nasty. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Peace.